Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. I also have a podcast where each week I cover another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. Hello and welcome. Today we're going to be talking about a 3D modeling tool called Resolve Non-Manifold. This tool is for fixing your 3D models so that they are ready for 3D printing and they render better. So it's a way to help you fix some 3D modeling errors you may run into. Now we'll talk about what manifold geometry is and what non-manifold geometry is and why it matters. So let's go ahead and jump into Cinema 4D and get started. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. I have a few examples here of what non-manifold geometry is. So let's go ahead and talk about this. So in order to 3D print something, it needs to have thickness, first of all. So something that cannot exist in real life is something that is infinitely thin, like this plane here. It has no thickness to it. It is a primitive and it's a very useful tool, but you cannot 3D print this, and this is considered non-manifold geometry. Our next example of non-manifold geometry also falls within the category of this does not have thickness and this cannot be 3D printed and it cannot exist in real life because these walls are infinitely thin. There's nothing that's infinitely thin like that in the world, and this is open. This can't exist. This isn't something we can 3D print. It's not a closed volume. There's no way we could make anything using a 3D printer with this. One quick way to try to fix this non-manifold geometry would actually to use the closed polygon hole tool, and I've gone over this in a previous lesson, so I'll actually leave a link to it in the description below if you want to learn all the settings for it. But the hotkey for it is M, and then in the hotkey menu you'll see that under D is closed polygon hole, so the hotkey for it is MD. So if I click D, I can go ahead and close this up in polygon mode, and now you can see that this is a closed model. I actually, when I use this tool, I like to turn on this option grid here because the edges look nicer and you have nicer loops. So that's how you can fix that kind of thing. In the situation of something like this that can't be 3D printed, you really just need to add some thickness to this, and you could use the thicken tool for something like that. If I were to select all these polygons, first I need to make this editable by hitting the C key because that was a primitive object. You can find your primitives in here and a plane. And then what you can do is select those, and you can add some thickness to this using the thicken tool here. And I'll leave a link if you're interested in learning all the settings for the thicken tool, because I went over that in another episode. But if I click and drag, you can see we are actually adding some thickness to this, and it is a closed mesh now. So we could 3D print this. The computer can make sense of this. This is something that can exist in real life. It is a closed volume. So now it is a manifold object. This is a manifold object. Now this one looks very similar to the other cube. I'll go ahead and select it here. This looks very similar to the other cube, but there is a difference here. And I'll actually go ahead and move these both up so that we can take a look at what's the difference between these two cubes. So this one is a manifold now. This one is a non-manifold because there's something else that can keep your object from being understood by the computer as a closed object than just having a hole in it. So what I'll do is I'll select all the polygons for this one and this one, and you'll notice something about it. This one is completely orange, and this one has these two purple polygons on the top. That is an error. So another way you can see this is if we go within our options and we turn on polygon normals, you can see the normal direction of all these polygons. So what those colors are signifying to us is what is the inside of this polygon and what's the outside of this polygon. And that helps your computer make calculations for 3D printing. It helps your computer render and know how to calculate bounces of light off of one object to another. What's the inside of the object? What's the outside of the object is really important for things like that. So you can see this is actually a non-manifold object because it cannot be read by the computer as a closed shape. So how would we go about fixing this? Well, there's actually quite a few ways you could go about fixing it. And we've gone over a couple in the episode on normals. So I'll leave a link to that below if you're interested in learning more about that. But you can click on this, these two that are going the wrong direction, and you can use reverse normals in order to change their direction. Now you can see that they're pointing upwards. I'm going to hit undo so that it is incorrect again. Another option is I could select all of these and I could choose to use align normals, and it'll just detect those two normals that are going in the wrong direction and point them in the right direction. I'll go ahead and undo that again because there's a third way to fix this. And if you go within the mesh menu, you'll see that there's another tool in here under clone called Resolve Non-Manifold. Now you may be wondering, why would this Resolve Non-Manifold tool be within the clone menu? And there's a good reason for that, because one way that it tries to fix non-manifold geometry is by breaking apart your model into islands. It can also be used to fix the normal direction. So I'm guessing that that is why Maxon decided to list this within the clone menu. And I'll go over what I mean in a moment by resolve non-manifold can split your geometry into separate parts. In this case, if we use it, it will just fix the normals here, and it's not going to separate anything. So it depends a little bit on the situation. So if I go ahead and click this, you can see that it fixed the normal direction, and that's how that works. So let's go ahead and talk a little bit more about what also can be considered non-manifold geometry. So we were talking about how non-manifold geometry cannot be 3D printed. Something else that can't be 3D printed is when surfaces come together at a point in space. So mathematically, these are infinitely getting closer to this infinitely small point in space. And that just can't exist in reality. Something taking up that exact point in space, it cannot happen in real life. It's how the computer is making sense of this 3D model. And you can see that if I were to go into polygon mode and I were to try to grab this part of the model, these are really connected. This point is welded. These are not two separate objects. These are connected. And if you were to try to 3D print this, it would not work. The computer would not know how to make sense of that. And it'll cause you some errors. You can't do that. As we mentioned, sometimes what Cinema 4D will try to do with the non-manifold, resolve non-manifold, is separate parts. And that's why this is in the clone menu. And the clone menu includes what helps duplicate and what helps separate, because it creates separate objects, it organized it that way. So hopefully that helps you remember what this is and where it is and where to find it, because there's a ton of these buttons in here and a ton of tools. But if we click this button here, you'll see something different happen. If I click that, And I try to now move this part away. It is completely separate now. And that's how it corrected it. This could be 3D printed now because they're two separate parts that are fully closed and are volumes. And Cinema 4D won't become confused by these taking up the same point in space. So that's one way it tries to resolve this error. So these are non-manifold, or these are now manifold objects. This is another example of this, but instead of having two objects, you'll see that this is considered non-manifold because it shares a point. So if I were to highlight that, or highlight actually, let's go ahead and grab this entire polygon here. You can see if I move this, these are attached. If I use the resolve non-manifold on these two, I'll actually go ahead and select both of them before I do that. If I were to use the resolve non-manifold on these within our clone menu and click on this, now we can go ahead and choose one of these polygons and you'll see it is now separate. Now, in theory, this helped fix one of the problems. This is still considered non-manifold geometry. You would have to thicken these so that they could be 3D printed and exist in real life in order to have this truly be a manifold object. There is another kind of object that is considered non-manifold, and it's actually just if you were to have a point in space. So if I have this object selected and I go into point mode and I click on create point, and I'm going to hit the middle mouse button to see my four views, hit the middle mouse button again in the top view. Then I'll hit control and click off here so that we just add a point to space. This point here is considered a non-manifold object. You cannot hold that. You cannot 3D print it. It's an infinitely small point in space. Right there. So that's considered non-manifold. It has no thickness. That's good to keep in mind. Now, the way you can fix this is actually another tool called Optimize. So we went over this again previously, so this might be a good review for some of you. But if you hit the U button and you hit O, you'll see Optimize is listed there, and that will remove any points you have in space that shouldn't be there, that aren't connected to anything else, because you cannot 3D print that and you'll run into errors. The computer won't know what to do with that information if you have a point there. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, please hit like and subscribe so that you'll see the next episode when it comes out. I cover another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D each week, and I really hope to see you again here. Thank you for 3D modeling with me, and I hope to see you again next week here on Ambient 3D Animations.